Hello everybody, this is the unboxing of the Yvonne 100 Master Grade Wing Zero Custom Version Gatoki, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So yeah, they went and done it. They gave us another Wing Zero Custom. It does feel weird because we've had different versions of the Wing Zero Custom lately. Especially me, because I've done a couple of the Supernova ones, which I really, really like, so... Hopefully, I'm sure this will be good too. See, that one is, the Supernova one is based off the, what is it, the metal composite? And then there's the other one that's the, high resolution, which I've done a couple of versions of that as well. But I do like the Wing Zero Custom, it is pretty cool. And the fact that this one can transform is also very nice. I do like the transformation. I don't mind them that they've kind of retconned the Wing Zero Custom to have that. Because I always liked the Wing Gundam and the original Wing Zero transforming, so... Personally, I'm okay with that. And it is kind of cool that the original Wing Zero, or the Wing Gundam EW, was one of the earlier Gatoki version kits. And now we have a Wing Zero Custom that's a Gatoki. It does make sense. I'm sure people are kind of want something else. I could go for an Exia version Gatoki. Hint, hint, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I mean, why not? Because how many Gatoki kits that aren't Universal Century have we gotten besides Wing Gundams? I can't think of any, actually. Maybe there are, but I don't think there. I think the Wing Gundam and the Wing EW and the Wings are custom here are the only two. So yeah, we can go for something else. Give me an Exia, please, because after the Ver.Ka comes out next year, this year, next should be a new Exia. Amazing how I can take something like the Wing Zero Custom and make it all about Exia, but yeah. Just how it is. Are these new beams or the old ones? 2000. These are the same freaking beams, I think, from the original version Gatoki. EW. I think. That's funny. There's a lot of plates here. Quite a few plates. Or the inner frame, which is I just noticed it's more like a gunmetal. There's the duplicate plate for that. And it does come with a stand. For those of you who have space, which is not me. And then we have a small sticker sheet. I like how they went for more of a kind of a turquoise color for the cameras. And water slide decals, holy crap. It's been a while since I've seen an official Bandai kit. New one. With water slide. So, yeah, I like that. And very cool looking instruction manual. There's some nice pictures. Of course, all the kind of like iconic poses. And of course, the hero figure has to be doing that hand up to his face. Oh, they're not showing all the plates you need. I always like that. I kind of gotten used to it. I wonder why they don't do that. Do they not do that with Gatoki? I can't remember. I'd have to look back on the last one I did, which was the Faz. I don't know why you wouldn't. Just makes things a little easier. And these wings. Now, the reason I'm actually building this kit right now is because there is a third-party add-on that I just got in the mail from Gundam Central, and I'm hoping it'll fit on this guy. I don't know, because it came out, obviously, before this guy did, but, obviously. But yeah, it came out before, so who knows? It might. Oh, whoa, the cannon... Oh, wait, the Buster Rifle collapses? Finally, you can store on the wings and it'll actually make sense. Wow, that already makes the kit way better. Foldable buster rifles. I am 100% down with that. Wow. I never knew how much I wanted that until I see it. So if you want to pick the kit up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam. And I'll see you in the next review.